We have revealed how hospitals have become warehouses for abandoned and unwanted at-risk adults, like Jerry Ellingson, found abandoned and wandering around at DIA. He ended up stranded in the hospital alone for 6 months. A few ideas from viewers on how to help people like Jerry. Sophia calls for more aggressive measures. Leandra asks, why couldn't we open a state Medicaid-ran facility just for at-risk adults? Caregivers are writing us, some who are struggling themselves. Karen has a mom with dementia in a facility. I think there is enough money to allow her to stay about 3 more months, and then I have no idea what my sister and I are going to do. Anne is trying to figure out how to care for her mother who had strokes. The owner has evicted my mother at this facility. Now she has nowhere to go. State lawmakers are paying attention to our reporting too, like Republican Senator Beth Martinez Humenik, who wants nursing homes and hospitals to work together.
Hospitals should want to be and should be willing to help the communities that they're in, but we need to work together to find the answers that are going to work for Colorado and for the people who deserve to be treated with dignity and respect.
Democratic lawmaker Jonathan Singer comes from a social work background.
Well, the silver tsunami's coming, whether we like it or not. In the next 10 or 20 years, we're all going to be experiencing this in some way or another, and we can either get ahead of it or we can let it crash over us. And so this is a real opportunity that you've actually helped with. Channel 9 has shown a light on something that we as legislators need to step up to the plate and start problem solving.